क्लास ट्वेल्थ, सब्जेक्ट फिजिक्स, सेवन्थ चैप्टर वेव ऑप्टिक्स, फ्रॉम द चैप्टर इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट। सो टू स्टडी इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट, लेट अस कंसीडर द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ सुपरपोजिशन ऑफ द वेव्स, विच इज स्टेटेड एज व्हेन टू और मोर दैन टू वेव्स ट्रैवलिंग थ्रू ए मीडियम अराइव एट ए पॉइंट ऑफ द मीडियम साइमल्टेनियसली, ईच वेव प्रोड्यूसेस इट्स ओन डिस्प्लेसमेंट एट दैट पॉइंट इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द अदर। द रिजल्टेंट डिस्प्लेसमेंट एट दैट पॉइंट इज इक्वल टू द वेक्टर सम ऑफ द डिस्प्लेसमेंट्स ड्यू टू दीज वेव्स। एंड देयरफॉर इन ऑर्डर टू स्टडी द इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ लाइट, लेट अस कंसिडर द टू सोर्सेस ऑफ लाइट S1 and S2, which are coherent sources of light, which are separated by a short distance. So both these sources of light, S1 and S2, will emit light waves in all possible direction. For simplicity, let us consider the light waves which are emitted towards right of these sources S1 and S2. As light waves are transverse in nature, therefore they will emit the light waves in the form of alternate crust and trough. In this diagram, the continuous lines will represent the crust, and these dotted lines will represent the trough. And therefore, when alternate crust and trough are originated from sources S1 and S2, they will get superimposed. There will be mixing of these light waves, so that along one particular line, for this line, there will be overlapping between crust of the wave emitted from S1 and crust of the wave emitted from S2. Similarly, trough of the wave emitted by S1 and trough of the wave emitted by S2 will also overlap. And therefore, when there is overlapping like this, when there is overlapping between the crust of one wave and crust of the other, or trough of one wave and trough of the other, there will be increase in the intensity of light, so that along these lines it will form the maximum, that is, intensity of these points will be maximum. These points are called as bright points. On the other hand, when there is overlapping between crust of one wave and trough of the other emitted from S1 and S2, then there will be decrease in the intensity of light, which will form minimum, which is called as dark points. And therefore, in this process, this will be the central maximum at the center of S1 and S2, and on either side of this central maximum, there will be alternate minimum and maximum produced. So this phenomenon will give rise to interference of light. And therefore, interference of light is defined as the modification in the intensities or amplitudes of the light waves due to the superposition of the waves. Interference is defined as the modification in the intensities of light or amplitudes of the light waves due to the superposition of the waves. Now, if you consider these points, these are the maximum and these are the minimum. In this diagram, maximum intensity points are shown by dots and the minimum intensity points are shown by the circles. And therefore, as there are maxima and minima produced on the either side of the central maximum, hence there are two types of interference, that is, constructive interference and destructive interference. So when there is overlapping between crust of one wave and crust of the other, or trough of one wave and trough of the other, then there will be constructive interference. When there is overlapping between crust of one wave and trough of the other, there will be destructive interference. And therefore, interference will be having two types, that is constructive interference, where the intensity of light is maximum, and the destructive interference, where the intensity of light is minimum. So depending upon this, experimentally, the interference of light can be studied with the help of Young's double slit experiment. So let us see the construction of this Young's double slit experiment. It contains the source S, which will emit light waves in all possible directions. So these are the rays of light which are emitted from this source S. All these rays of light are allowed to fall on this convex lens. Therefore, this convex lens will make these all rays of light which are incident on it parallel to each other, and therefore we will get a parallel beam of light. Then this parallel beam of light is allowed to fall on the two slits S1 and S2. So S1 and S2 are the two slits which are separated by a small distance. Then the light waves emitted from S1 and S2 will interfere, and this interference pattern will be obtained. It will be observed on the screen PQ. So PQ is the screen on which interference pattern will be observed. Now how it will take place? So when this parallel beam of light is incident on the slits S1 and S2, both these slits S1 and S2 will act as coherent sources of light. Hence, they will emit light waves in the form of alternate crust and trough. Here also, continuous lines will represent crust and dotted lines will represent trough. So that interference phenomenon will take place, and there at the center of S1 and S2 along this line, there will be overlapping between crust-crust and trough-trough. Crust-crust and trough-trough will overlap, and hence constructive interference will take place, and it will give rise to maximum, that is bright point, bright band will be obtained on the screen. On either side of this central bright band along this line, there will be overlapping between crust of one wave and trough of the other. So along this line, crust of one wave and trough of the other will now overlap, and hence destructive interference will take place, so that we will get the points of minimum intensity here, which are the dark points or dark bands. Then again, there will be overlapping between crust-crust and trough-trough, crust-crust and trough-trough along this line, so that again constructive interference will take place, and it will give rise to a bright point. So that on either side of this central maximum, there will be alternate minimas and maximas, that is points of higher intensity and lower intensity will be produced, and this will give rise to the interference pattern. So interference pattern consists of the central bright band, and on either side of the central bright band there will be alternate bright and dark bands. Initially, this experiment was carried on by using the sunlight as the source, and here the pinholes were used in place of S1 and S2, and the interference pattern was observed on the screen. But that interference pattern was colored interference pattern, since sunlight is not monochromatic light, and therefore to study the interference, the light waves which are emitted from these two sources S1 and S2 must be monochromatic, having single wavelength, only one wavelength. But after that, this sunlight was replaced by the monochromatic source of light such as sodium vapor lamp, and then The pinholes were replaced by the two slits S1 and S2, and clear interference pattern was obtained on this screen. Now, if you consider this Young's double slit experiment, the geometry of this double slit experiment we will have to study. That means mathematical expression we will have to obtain by considering geometry of double slit experiment. So for that purpose, here S1 and S2 are the two coherent sources. S1 and S2 represents two coherent sources separated by distance d. O is the center of S1, S2, and so that let us draw perpendicular from the center, that is O, O dash, on the screen. Then the perpendiculars are drawn on the screen from S1 and S2 also, and therefore S1, S1 dash and S2, S2 dash are the perpendiculars drawn, and hence this distance d will get divided into two equal parts, and therefore S1O equal to d by 2 and S2O equal to also d by 2. Now, when the light waves emitting from S2 and S1 reach to this point O dash on the screen, the equal distance will be covered by these two waves, and hence there will be no any path difference. That is, path difference between these two waves reaching point O dash from S1 and S2 will be equal to zero. And hence, it will give rise to that point O dash as the central maximum point. Now, let us consider the two rays of light coming from S1 and S2 and reaching the point P on the screen, which is at a distance equal to y from the central point O dash. Now the path difference will be there because distance S1P will be small as compared with S2P. So that as unequal distances are covered by these light waves from S1 and S2 to reach point P, so that there is path difference. Now that path difference will be nothing but the difference between the two distances, that is S2P and S1P. So when these waves reach to that point P, it will interfere there, and so that point P may be dark or bright depending upon the value of that path difference. Now capital D represents the distance between the sources and the screen, that is capital D distance. Now the path difference for that point P between the two rays S1P and S2P will be equal to S2P minus S1P. So that is the path difference. Now one more construction will be done, that is, let the angle between S2P and S2S dash is equal to theta. If this angle is theta, now let us draw a perpendicular from S1 on this S2P. That is, this is the perpendicular drawn. Now why this perpendicular is drawn? So because if the perpendicular is drawn here, therefore this point S1 and this point meeting point of S2P and that perpendicular will be in the same phase. That is, this distance up to point P and S1P, these two distances will be same, and this extra distance from S2 to this perpendicular will be the path difference. So that in order to calculate the value of that path difference, if this angle is theta, this triangle will be right angle triangle, so that this angle will be 90 minus theta. At S2, the angle will be in that triangle 90 minus theta. This angle is 90 degree, so that this angle will be theta. And therefore, from this triangle, this distance is the path difference, that is S2P minus S1P. That distance we will get as the path difference. In order to calculate the value of this path difference, let us consider the two right angle triangles, that is S2P S2 dash and S1P S1 dash. These are the two right angle triangles. So this is S2P S2 dash and then S1P S1 dash. These two right angle triangles we will have to consider, and therefore from triangle S2 dash P S2 dash P, that is from this triangle S2 dash P, from this right angle triangle, by using Pythagoras theorem, we can write S2P square equal to S2 dash square plus S2 dash P square. So square of the hypotenuse will be equal to addition of square of the two remaining sides. But S2 dash is D, and therefore we will get D square plus. Now what is S2 dash P? What is that S2 dash P? So this distance from P to O dash equal to Y, and O dash to S2 dash equal to D by 2. Therefore this total distance P S2 dash will be equal to Y plus D by 2. And that's why we can write D square plus Y plus D by 2 square. Now square this by using A plus B square, so that we will get D square plus Y square plus YD plus D square by 4 as equation 1. Same phenomenon will be now used for that triangle S1, S1 dash P, and therefore from this triangle S1P square equal to S1 S dash S1 dash square plus S1 dash P square. Again S1 S1 dash equal to D, therefore D square plus, now this S1 dash P, that distance will be from P to O dash, it is equal to Y, and therefore P S1 dash will be equal to Y minus this D by 2. And therefore we can write D square plus Y minus D square. Again squaring this, we will get D square plus Y square minus YD plus D square by 4, that is equation number 2. Now subtracting equation 2 from equation 1, we have to subtract equation 2 from this equation 1, we will get S2P square minus S1P square equal to D square plus Y square plus YD plus D square by 4 minus D square minus Y square plus YD minus D square by 4. Therefore S2P square minus S1P square equal to 2YD, because D square minus D square minus Y square and D square by 4 minus D square by 4 will get cancelled. And so that now this will be expanded, that is S2P plus S1P, S2P square minus S1P square will be now expanded as A square minus B square equal to A plus B and A minus B, S2P plus S1P into S2P minus S1P. So that will be equal to 2YD. Now S2P minus S1P, this S2P minus S1P is equal to 2YD upon S2P plus S1P. Now as point P is very close, because that interference pattern screen will be very very small, and therefore point P will be very very close to point O dash, and therefore S1P and S2P, these two distances will be nearly same, and it will be nearly parallel to D, therefore it will be equal to D, and therefore S2P minus S1P. But in this case still very very small difference will be there between S2P and S1P, and that's why that approximation is used only for the addition of S2P and S1P. And therefore, S2P minus S1P we will get as 2YD upon D plus D, that is equal to 2YD upon 2D, 2 will get cancelled, and therefore YD upon D. This is the path difference. S2P minus S1P is the path difference, and therefore path difference is equal to YD upon D. Now this path difference will now decide the nature of the interference bands, and therefore if this path difference is, if this path difference is integral multiple of wavelength, lambda will be the wavelength of the light used, n will be integer, and therefore for bright bands this path difference YND upon D must be equal to n lambda. That is, for bright bands the path difference between the two waves must be integral multiple of wavelength. On the other hand, for the dark bands this path difference YND upon D equal to n minus half into lambda. Now this factor n minus half will be in terms of fraction, that is in terms of half, and therefore this will represent the dark band, and therefore for dark band the path difference must be equal to or multiple of wavelength or half multiple of the wavelength. So in case of bright bands it is integral multiple of wavelength, and it is for dark bands half multiple of wavelength.